Okay guys, so we will quickly recap this chapter, that is chapter 1. See, after every chapter, as I have told you guys, once we finish full chapter, at the end we will quickly recap it. Sir, quickly recap means I won't be explaining anything here. Please be clear with that. Whatever I have already explained, we will be quickly going through that, because it will be like, okay, quick recap for you. Okay, this chapter was very small, so you may feel like, okay, why recap all those things? But coming days, the chapters will be huge. So we may take 2 or 3 days, 4 days to complete a chapter. In that case, revision is very important. So that is why we have planned the classes like this. So we'll be quickly revising this chapter. Then we'll start with second chapter. Clear guys? Yeah. Please pay attention. Is revision in just 4 or 5 minutes, maximum 10 minutes, we'll be revising entire chapter. Okay? Yeah. Tax, like as we already discussed, tax is a compulsory payment every citizen has to make to the government. Who has the power or authority to collect the tax? Central government. From where that power or authority is given? From the constitution. Clear? There are two types of taxes, that is direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax is the one where impact and incidence is on the same person. Example is income tax. Impact means that who is ultimately suffering the tax. Incidence means who had the liability to pay tax. Clear? Next, indirect tax. Indirect tax is the one where impact and incidence is on two different persons. Example is GST or customs. Next, canons of taxation. There are 4 canons of taxation. That is equity, certainty, convenience and economy. Equity should be based on ability to pay tax. If I have the ability to pay tax, higher my income, higher will be my tax liability. Then certainty, I should be knowing what tax I should pay, when I should pay, what is the rate applicable for me. There should be certainty. Agree? Next, convenience. So when I am paying my tax, filing my returns, everything should be available for me at my convenience. It should not be so much difficulty for me. Agree? Next, economy. For the government, the cost of collecting the tax must be as low as possible. Clear? Next, Constitution of India. So as I already told you guys, the power to levy taxes to the government is given by the Constitution. There are 2 articles which we are covering here, that is Article 265 will tell no tax shall be levied or collected except by the authority of law. Next, coming to 246 will distribute the powers to central government and state governments, or I can tell union and state legislative. Okay, so under 246 there is a schedule 7 which enumerates 3 lists: union list, legislative list and concurrent list. Union list will list out the taxes which can be levied by the central government, whereas legislative list is nothing but state list, which gives the list of the taxes which can be collected by the state government. Then concurrent list will give the power to both central government as well as state government, which can be collected by both simultaneously. Simultaneously, guys, as I told you, CGST, SGST, both will be levied together, not separately. Next, administration. Sir, what is this CGST, SGST? Please don't break your head, guys. I am just giving the example. Everything in detail in GST I will be explaining. I will make sure that you will not have any confusions there. Clear? Because now if I am explaining, sir, what is CGST, SGST, all those things, it will take more time for me. So instead of doing income tax, then I should start doing GST. So I am not getting into that in detail. Next, administration. As I have told you, the topmost authority here is Ministry of Finance. Under that, for revenue, there is a Department of Revenue. Under Department of Revenue, there is 2 wings: for direct taxes, CBDT, under CBDT, Income Tax Department. So these 2 departments will take care of anything which relates to direct taxes, income tax. Clear? Then second wing is indirect tax. CBIC is there. Under CBIC, GST Council is there. So these 2 things will take care of anything related to GST. Clear? CBIC also will take care of customs also. But GST Council is bothered only about GST, guys. Clear? Yeah.